Well, hello, my YouTube family. My new lights are here. So I don't know if you can see a difference or not. Because again, one came the way it was supposed to, and the other one didn't. But I'm working with them. I'm not going to bitch and moan just as long as you see. I can see. Everybody can see. Everything is copacetic. Let's just get lips of the day out of the way. I don't know if there's really much to talk about, but there is work stuff to talk about. So nothing, you know, major. But let's get started. I have done a lip look on this before, and this is a brown, in case you can't see, but it is a brown. And I don't do browns that much, but there is somebody out there. I don't know if you're still a family member of mine. I don't remember your name, of course. But I remember that you wanted me to do a lot of brown lipsticks. So this is one of the brown lipsticks. So let us get started, people. Let us start off with the liner, which is a very dark brown. So I had to really be very, very light. Because if you press on it too hard, it comes off as like a black liner, but it really isn't. It's NYX, and the color is called Espresso. And see how dark it is? It's almost like a brown black, but it is a lip liner. So I lined very lightly. And then another NYX, it's an NYX round lipstick. And this is in the color 594 Brown Sweet. 594 Brown Sweet. And this is what Brown Sweet looks like. That is Brown Sweet. And this is Brown Sweet. It's like a hot chocolate kind of a shade. That is Brown Sweet. So that is Brown Sweet. And ever so lightly, topped it with my MAC lip gloss. Ever so lightly. That's what's giving it the nice little shine. But you know, it's MAC lip gloss. It's a clear, so you're seeing the, it's not a combo. This is the actual shade, but with a touch of shine to it. So there you have it, people. That is lips of the day. Today was interesting because we had a potluck kind of situation going on where I had to buy the two cherry pies. That was my contribution. I ain't about to cook for these people, okay? So there were a lot of people that did, though. And it was very interesting. I had to actually ask permission to attend the festivities because, what, everybody was going to join in and they were just going to leave me in the reception area? Like, since my supervisor wants absolutely nothing to do with me, she didn't even offer. Like, Nancy, you could turn off, shut the phones off, and, you know, Ohio will take care of the calls because they'll be forwarded there. I had to actually email her and ask, is it okay if I shut the switchboard off for about an hour or so I can attend the festivities? And she said, yes, you can. Whew, got permission. So there you have it. That's it. That's all. It was a lot of fun. There was a lot of food. And there was just a lot of food. And I ate so much that when my actual lunch half hour, 30 minutes came, because this happened at 12:30. So when 2 o'clock came, I was not in the mood to go anywhere. So that, you know, I took my lunch with everybody else. I actually, you know, found a table that I knew some people in, because everybody tends to sit with their own department, and I'm not gonna sit with my department. So I sat with others, and because why should I be someplace where I'm not wanted? So I sat with people that I normally associate with and I talk to on a daily basis and this and that. So it was a lot of fun and it was very relaxed. And I had a good time, And we had food. There was turkey. There was chicken. There was curry chicken. There was barbecue chicken. There was pasta up the waz, macaroni and cheese. There was baked ziti. Rice and beans. And there was, there was a lot of food. There was vegetarian stuff. There was kosher stuff. There was ani. Food 4 days. Okay. I got my fair share. I ate what I ate. And I am still full. That's from 12:30 to what time is it now? Hold on. 6:46. I'm still full. So maybe I won't be having dinner tonight. I don't know. But fun was had by all. I sat with a good crew. And, that's basically it in a nutshell. We had a good time. We ate, laughed, and we were merry. And that was basically it. And then at precisely 1:30 or 1:45, everything was shut down. Tables were being folded up. Food was being taken back upstairs. So it was like, oh, I guess that's our cue that it's over now. Get back to work, slaves. Get back to work. So we went upstairs and, we were happy. You know, this was basically our bonus. That's basically it in a nutshell, because the woman who was Hopalong's supervisor or boss or whatever the heck you want to call her, she is basically the one that, well, it's really Hopalong who did most of the work. But of course, her supervisor is going to take the credit. She, you know, before we all ate, there were tables and everything. So she stood in front of everybody and pretty much said that it's been a hard year and we just wanted to show our appreciation. This was basically our bonus. Okay. Let's just call a thing a thing. Okay. This was just basically our bonus. We wanted to show our appreciation and how much work, we appreciate how hard you work for the company. And this, look, okay. Let's just call a thing a thing. I love that line by Yolanda Van Zandt. Let's just call a thing a thing. That's basically what it was. You're not going to get any funds, but you are going to cook for the company and we are going to have a potluck. So that's what it was. Some people cook for the company. Some people bought store-bought stuff. Let somebody else do the cooking. Okay, you can't say I didn't contribute, though. I spent money. Hello? You know, the money that we should have had, but we didn't get. So that was basically it in a nutshell, people. So that was that. It was a lot of fun. You know, I'm not trying to come across as unappreciative. So that was it. Next stop is the Christmas party next month. So we'll see how that goes. But in the meantime, that is behind us now. One full day today, one down. One and a half more to go because tomorrow is another full day. And then Wednesday, we leave at 3:00. So that is that with that upon that. So that's basically it in a nutshell. I have nothing else to tell you. This is Lips of the Day. My new lights are installed. They are, again, LED lights. So I don't know how long these are going to last. But you know what? I'm already shopping for backups, just in case. But this time, I'm not shopping for LED backups. I'm going to shop for, you know, regular bulb backups. Because I realize, you know, with LEDs, they're supposed to be the new thing. And, you know, my last LED light showed me that they don't really last that long. So, you know, just as long as I can find something cheap. I'm not about to spend no $199 for any kind of lights. I'm not about that life. I don't make YouTube a job for myself. I just love making videos. That's basically it in a nutshell. So I'm not going to, you know, I love my YouTube family. Just as long as you guys can see me. You know, you can see true colors. That's all that's necessary, right? I don't need any fancy backgrounds. I don't need any, you know, I got my shoes over here. Black Velcro sneakers. Yep, those are the ones I'm wearing. Mr. Man decided that he didn't want to show up tonight. He was here. I mean, he was lying. Actually, he was lying there on the right here. There. He was lying on top of that. But he decided he did not want to be the star of this video today. So he left before I started. Anyway, that's it. That's all I have to tell you today. On the drive home, I started to get excited about Thanksgiving. You know, sometimes it could take you a while to work your way up. But I was like, oh, okay, I'm looking forward to it now. But let me tell you what happened to me this morning. I mean, as serious as a heart attack. I woke up this morning and I swore. You couldn't tell me nothing. I swore that it was Friday. Like, I woke up, I was like, whew, God, it's Friday. Thank goodness it's Friday. And then I literally had to stop myself. Like, I had to sit back down on the bed and I go, wait a minute. Wait just a damn moment. This is not Friday. This is Monday, Nancy. Yesterday, you did the laundry. That's Sunday. So, And I literally had to sit for a moment to gather myself because my body was all about Friday. It was like, wow, it's Friday. Okay, this is great. Well, first of all, if it were Friday, that would be the day after Thanksgiving. So even though you would not be going to work, why would you be waking up that early? That's number one. Number two, if it were Friday, that means Thanksgiving would have already happened. Oh, I was majorly confused. Majorly confused this morning. It's old age. Did anybody see the American Music Awards last night? What? Jennifer Lopez, honey. I've never been a 100%, you know, woo-hoo J-Lo fan, but I liked her. I liked her ever since she did the movie Selena. I was for her to do Selena even before the movie came out. Because I used to see her when she was up and coming, doing a few acting gigs here and there. And she had Selena's curly hair and everything. And I'm like, if ever they needed to do a Selena movie, she'd be the perfect chick. Sure enough. Tell me I can't do casting. Tell me I can't do casting. Oh, and, huh, wait just a moment, people. Wait just a hot moment. I didn't see the first hour, but I caught up with the second hour because I was watching something else, which escapes me now, which was definitely better than what I was watching, which I'm about to talk about now, 50 Shades of Grey. I missed the first hour because I was watching something else. Maybe Da Vinci's Demons. Maybe that's what I was watching. And then I caught the second hour of 50 Shades of Grey. Can I just say that I am so beyond thrilled and proud of Henry Cavill for turning down the role of this Grey person, this Mr. Grey, whoever the hell, Christian Grey, whatever his name is. Yeah. No. This movie was a piece of crap, honey. This movie was a... And they're going to make a part two and a part three because the author wrote three different shades of gray or something. And they wanted Henry Cavill to do the second one. Please, sweet Jesus, tell him no. Because this is crap. And maybe he knows it's crap. So I think he turned it down. He knows better. This would not skyrocket, catapult his career in any kind of way. Okay. Superman did that. So Man of Steel. No, he shouldn't touch this. He shouldn't touch this piece of crap. At all. At all. Even if he was in it, he still wouldn't have improved the movie. Looks wise, yeah, because he's hot. But this movie was a piece of crap. Like, I really don't understand. I don't understand what the point was. This was a guy who was into whips and chains and bondage, and she got into it. And she was falling in love with him. I couldn't tell whether he was falling in love with her or not because he didn't want to open himself up. And then she... Now, here's the thing. This is what really flipped me over and made me roll my eyes to the nth degree. oh, Christian, I just want you to tell me. I want you to open up to me. And I want you to, you know, express your feelings to me. And what is it that you really want to do to me? And he was like, you're not going to like it. And she goes, no, you know, you just do what you do to me what you always wanted to do to me. So he does, beats the shit out of her, you know, with whips. 6 times he whips her. And he wanted her to count with him how many times. He whipped her ass. So he whipped her ass. Then he unties her. And she's like, don't ever do that to me again. I don't ever want to speak to you again. Bitch, you asked him to show you what it was that he wanted to do to you. And he said, no, he didn't want to do that. But you begged and pleaded. And so he does. And then when he lets you loose, don't you ever do that to me again. What? And then it ends with her going into the elevator and he's chasing her and she turns around and she goes, no. And she steps into the elevator and he says her name and then she says his name and that's the end of the movie. What? Thank Jesus I did not spend money on that piece of crap. Because there's no way. Plus, I heard and I read through the grapevine and heard through the grapevine that the book itself is written in such an immature and unpolished way. But they sex sells, honey. Sex sells. Whatever a book is, if it's got a whole lot of sex in it, it's going to sell. Whether it makes sense or not. And so that was that. So I'm glad I didn't have to pay. Oh, that's what it was. That's what I was watching. Because I said pay. I was watching Man from U.N.C.L.E. I was watching Henry in that movie. I watched Man from U.N.C.L.E. So I had to pay for that. That's why I remembered it. So after Man from U.N.C.L.E., I caught the last hour of 50 Shades of Grey. And I'm so glad I just caught the last hour because I don't know if I could have dealt with starting it from 8 o'clock to 10. Because, no, boo-boo. No. That was an insult to my intelligence. It really was an insult to my intelligence. Like, this is the book that all the housewives and everybody was so, ooh, 50 Shades of Grey, and ooh, it's so hot, and really? And this is the movie? That's what became of the book? Maybe the book was better. I don't know. But if that's what it was all about, and then he takes her on a plane ride and, you know, I thought you didn't do romance and I don't. And but you tell her that, what are you doing to me? And you're changing me. And okay. No, but the part where he whips her ass and then she tells him, don't ever do that to me again. He already warned you that you would not like what he's about to do to you. Oh no, please, you know, I want you to open up to me. I want you to share with me. Okay, bitch, you asked for it. And then when he does, don't you ever touch me. Don't you ever do this to me again. What? Okay, you know what? I'm just glad it's over. It's over, it's done with. And I saw Man from U.N.C.L.E. and it was a really cute movie and it was a lot of fun to watch, but I'm not buying it. I love Henry, y'all know, but this is one that I can pretty much do without in my library of movies. I can just take a pass. Now the next movie that I'm anxious to see is the Star Wars movie. I really don't know if I'll be able to see it in the theaters. Because, you know, tickets have already been sold out and I didn't buy my ticket. So, good luck, Nance. Okay, so that is it, people. That is it. That is all. I love you. I love my YouTube family. Hit me up. Let me know what you think. If any of y'all have seen the movie or even read that sad, pitiful book, don't be ashamed. I'm your family member. You're my family member. Let me know. Let me know what you thought. Maybe there's something in the movie that I didn't see or I didn't get, or because it didn't turn me on at all. Okay, I'm not into all that bondage shit. It's just not my cup of tea. So just let me know if you saw the movie and or read the book. And let me know what you thought about it. And maybe you saw something that I did not see or I didn't catch on to, or, you know. Okay, so I'm curious. I'm curious to know if any of you have read the book and or saw the movie and what you thought about it. I'm curious to know. I'm not going to, you know, everybody's got they're entitled to their own opinions. You have your own tastes. I have my own tastes. That's just the way it's going to be. But I'm curious to know what you have to say. I love you. I love my YouTube family. Hit me up. Let me know what you think. Like I said, I've done a lip look on this before. And I will talk to you tomorrow. Okay? That's one down, one and a half more to go. So you will see me two more times. And then you guys won't see me until the following Tuesday. Because I'm off that Monday. I'm off the 30th. So we'll discuss again on Wednesday. Okay? When I come home early. Okay? I love you. Mwah. Bye now.